Tools for sustainable remote work in 2021. Let's understand tasks, and with tasks, we see that okay, there are two main types of tasks, right? We have solo tasks and we have collaborative tasks, and that really now gives us a framework to kind of understand some basic tools that I want to talk about today. Again, this is not an exhaustive list. This is just to get you started in the remote work or the remote economy, you know, play. Now, the next important tools that you would require as once you have a team, once or even as a, on a personal note. You would require some kind of collaboration or task management software, right? This is really where all your tasks come in, project management, you know, different projects, campaigns, or you could have, you know, people there assign the tasks. So really our, you know, go-to for the past, you know, 10 years, I would say, we're probably using Asana since 2010 or 2011, one of the earliest customers, I'm sure, in India. And we love it, right? So nothing really gets us out of Asana. That's still, you know, early morning. I mean, morning, you know, that's when we check in and connect at office. And that's the last thing we see at night before we close, wind up. Of course, people could use Slack. There are other project management tools like Trello, etc. Some people also use Notion. I think it's a nice new tool that's come about where people can, you know, really use it in any kind of way you want, much like Asana. It's got some, you know, it's a note-taking app that you can really structure into a CRM, into a hiring tool, into a bug tracker. Yeah, really, really cool software. So, of course, I use Kanban Flow internally for my own kind of, you know, I have a lot of moving parts many times. So I like Kanban Flow internally that I use for my own tasks and projects. Now, another important thing that you would need is, of course, graphic design. I think today, design is one of the critical components of the whole remote work, remote economy. So graphic design, of course, you know, my recommendation is Canva. You could also, you know, people are into Photoshop, Illustrator, et cetera, right? So really graphic design is a very, very important, you know, kind of, you need a tool for graphic design. If you don't have a designer, and even if you have a designer, the designer would need tools. So graphic design tools, I recommend Canva. I think, you know, it's really cool. You could use Figma, mockups. Coming to the last two, three kind of tools here to wrap this, you know, very, very quickly. Of course, everybody is you know, the old school, right? The old school is again, Office, Microsoft Office tools, your Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Of course, if you're on Mac, you're on, you know, Numbers, Keynote, you know, so Pages. So really, no matter what happens, still at the end of the day, sometimes we will end up going to a Keynote or going to a Pages document, right? Not everything's done on other tools. The most important component to automate your life or to be able to live this remote economy, the payment gateway. It's really how you collect payments from your customers. You of course have options here. You could, you know, go in with people with providers like Stripe. You could use like Razorpay or CC Avenue, like a whole bunch of providers here, right? So you can really use any of these payment gateways to be able to collect payments. So it's another important tool, and it'll also help you in your tracking of your customers. Appointment scheduling. These days we have seen this something new that's come. This is really about, you know, people able to book your calendar or book your time. This could be like an office hours or, you know, something like that. So you need a tool that you can, you know, send out to people. You need a link to send out to people where they can easily book your available times, right? So it's very, very important to have an appointment scheduling software. Of course, goes without saying, again, back to the old school, long form content is going to be very, very big in 2021 SEO. So, you know, again, blog is really your mouthpiece as a company. And really, you know, that's what drives a lot of SEO as well. And some authentic, great content, right? Nothing quite like text, long post text content. So have a blog, of course, you know, WordPress, Medium, you could use any of these, you know, providers. And of course, the last thing in the tools, of course, it's not an exhaustive list. I've just put together a few here. Analytics, right? So really, really critical. Before even you have your website up, I would say have your analytics. So you would have Google Analytics, you would have, you know, Hotjar, you would have Amplitude, you would have Mixpanel. So you would have all of these, you know, kind of tools on the analytics side.